my name is Ryan Dark, and I'm a certified SOLIDWORKS application engineer here at GoEngineer. In this GoEngineer Quick Tips video, I will be discussing the pitfalls of using the automatic lid generation within flow simulation. As you can see in the model before me, I have gone ahead and inserted three different lids into the three different entries into my T intersection here. These lids are just auto-generated, so I've done really no construction on them except to, in this case, make one of them not function. I won't tell you which one. So when I go to try to define a boundary condition, I make my selection. I leave all the defaults for a flow inlet boundary, and I get this error: face is not lined on the boundary between solid and fluid region. Now, this can be a little more troubling if you have a lot of entrances and exits to your model. You'd have to normally go through and check each one and ensure that you have a proper contact between the lid and the model to close off all of these entrances. But today we're just going to throw all that aside and just look at a different way of modeling this flow simulation. So for that, I'm just going to actually go into just the part itself. The part I've shelled out so that I have my three entrances. So going back over to the model, I'm going to actually change this shell definition to not have any faces. So I'm clearing all the selections, I press OK, it still shells my part, but it doesn't leave any openings to the interior. So the interior right now is completely closed off in the same way that lids would close it off, but I'm guaranteed that the interior is shut off and ready for a flow analysis. So if I go over here to my flow simulation, I update my model geometry, my boundary conditions, go ahead and make the model transparent once more, and I define a boundary condition. The boundary condition doesn't need to be on a lid face, it just needs to be on a face that is on a boundary of a fluid domain. So if I do a select other command here, and I select the face that was previously my lid, go ahead and accept, it accepts it. I zoom in, you can see I have now a flow inlet boundary coming in my 2-inch pipe. I can go ahead and do the same thing on my other former lid entrances. Select other, select that inside face on my fluid boundary, and I can insert a pressure boundary condition. And from there, I can just go up to flow simulation, solve, run, and let it go. And in this case, I didn't have to spend a lot of time trying to diagnose what was wrong with my lids. I just closed off the interior of my geometry to see how the flow is going to go, and I didn't worry necessarily about this being realistic to create, because you're not going to make an object with a cavity and no entrances, but in this case for flow simulation it's kind of handy. So this has been Ryan Dark with GoEngineer. I hope you enjoyed this video. Check out our other videos for more tips on using SOLIDWORKS.